I like that. Don't you like Ben's hat? That corduroy?
That looks really good. It's very hard to find a hat with no logo on it. That's for the elite.
Yeah. That's kind of how I felt about this. I don't want to wear anything with a logo
anything
anymore.
With logos?
Yeah.
I think I'm getting out of that too. I'm starting to buy like adult clothes.
Yeah.
I feel smarter.
Yeah.
I feel better about myself.
My version of adult clothes is just going to Target and being like, what is the cheapest black sweater that you have?
I'm starting to wear more adult clothes. Like, I love those Sriracha shirts at Target and Run DMC. And I wear like a Bob the Builder backpack.
Mm-hmm. Once a year, I buy a Chewbacca Santa Claus sweater. Yeah. That says, may the force be with you this Christmas.
I saw a guy walking his dog with a shirt that said Yoda best dad.
Hell yeah.
With Baby Yoda on it.
Yeah.
Really?
Don't you want to, just when you see that guy, just take out a gun and shoot him in the head right there on the sidewalk?
Adults like that wearing like young adult t-shirts, they do make me sick to my stomach, you know? Like a guy with like, it's like a 45-year-old man and he's got a shirt where it's like a squirrel and it's like, protect your nuts.
He's trying to bond with his school shooter son, mm-hmm. essentially.
You're mm-hmm. just wearing a shirt that winds up on a homeless schizophrenic man at some point. You know, you see like a homeless guy and he's wearing like an NSYNC t-shirt. And you're like, there's no way you love NSYNC.
Yeah, he's wearing like a Spice Girls. It's got sparkles on it. Malibu Barbie and he's shooting heroin.
He's like, the sparkles help with the warmth.
You might as well just steal the clothes they're going to give to African children after the Patriots lose the Super Bowl.
You're just wearing New England Patriots 2007 Super Bowl champion shirts. And,
yeah. I love that every year there's a shirt that's either going to be worn by Rob Gronkowski or a kid with a giant extended belly in Senegal somewhere.
They're using it to purify water. It's like the beginning of Uncut Gems. They're all wearing Patriots gear.
Sorry, Emma was wearing her Jingle Bell collar.
A guy has a 2007 Super Bowl champ Patriots tied around the nub of his hand that got caught off by fucking African warlords.
And Joseph Kony's wearing like a Corey Dillon jersey.
Yeah, well, he's trying to shove a diamond up his ass to sneak out of them, just cutting his ass open.
Just all the child soldiers wearing the sports team gear.
Mm-hmm. Remember the Kony guy?
I'll get better at sports stuff. Oh, the Kony 2012 guy?
Yeah, remember they found him...
Jacking
off in San Diego.
Yeah. Masturbating, yeah.
Yeah, he's like the dad of the Colorado shooter.
Of the non-binary man.
Yeah. It is very funny. I had a couple friends who'd be like, I can't believe we live in a society that... I'm like, the guy was fucking crazy. Yeah,
the people sharing that clip of that guy, like, he's a normal man with normal thoughts, was amazing. They're like, this is disgusting. It's like, he's a meth head in front of a trailer.
You're talking about the dad?
Yeah, the Sling Blade looking guy.
You know what's interesting?
Sling Blade porn actor.
And I'm glad we got into the shooting immediately.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah.
Because I had some more stuff to say about the Target t-shirts, but let's move right into the...
Okay, we can circle back.
No. We're going to move right into the shooting.
People say we need a theme. So the theme, we could do Target t-shirts, mm-hmm. and every episode ends with a big cap.
Yep.
Yeah, we'll run a segment every week called Fact or Cap, yo. Mm-hmm. And we just review TikToks to see if they're in fact cap or not.
Dude, Ben, Coke or Pepsi?
You want to argue about stuff?
Dude, let's get a big argument about food.
Fucking hot eggplant parmesan? Are you fucking kidding me?
I love to feign interest in things like Pepsi.
Me too. I love that. Mm. As a grown man.
What's great is no one can tell that I'm pretending to be upset about things for entertainment purposes.
Dude, no one can
tell. Because everyone has complete and total brain damage, apparently.
It is insane. Mm,
but regardless...
We don't have to get into what we're talking about.
The people know. They were basically shaming mm-hmm. this man who was a sex worker.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because he was crazy. He was in porn. I'm like, wait, hold on. Mm-hmm. Why is that?
Why is that a problem?
Why is that not okay?
Yeah. And then they give me shit when I say Mia Khalifa did 9/11. Get called a racist.
Racist. Mia Khalifa's in a cave somewhere.
She's in a bada bad.
Yeah. It turns out she was in a bada bad the whole time. I would love to see that whole sequence remade with just them killing Mia Khalifa. Them breaking in to run a train on her.
Yeah.
The helicopter goes down. The guy's in the stairway going, Mia, Mico Leiva.
Zero Dark 30.
Yeah, she peeks her head around. He just jizzes right in her eye.
That was still Team 6 or still Team 10?
6.
Still Team 6. What's interesting is they all apparently wrote books where they all have conflicting stories that happen. I haven't read. I'm clearly not reading any Navy SEAL books.
Right. That's an audiobook only.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure. But they're all conflicting. And the other day I was going through Osama bin Laden's computer files. They're on the...
Yeah, you have the hard
have
drive
them?
Somehow.
They uploaded
Ben,
the...
Ben got in James Cameron's submarine to find Osama's body. It's like the Discover Titanic documentary.
I'll prove it to you because people don't believe me. I'm going to type in... Watch me, boys.
All okay. Right.
Watch me go.
Osama bin Laden.
Autofilling, of course. What are you typing? Files, CIA computer.
Here we go. CIA.gov library, Abbottabad compound. November 2017 release of Abbottabad compound material. And now, boys, I have, you want to do audio, documents, images, or video? I got 162 gigabytes of video that was on Osama bin Laden's computer. Now, what's interesting about this, if you go through a lot of the files, one of them is a BBC documentary about dolphins. He has full episodes of Tom and Jerry on there.
Yeah. Well, he liked to get high. He was high a lot. They had tons of, like,
so he's like
kush.
A Cheech and Chong.
He was just getting high after organizing 9/11 and then watching, like, dude, the dolphins. It's so beautiful.
He's like, put on Joe Rogan, Paul Stamets episode. This should blow your mind, man. I swear to God, if I knew this in 2000, those towers still stand, bro.
He's watching Homeland. He, like, torrented Homeland.
It would be great if he had, like, a compilation of Brian Redman saying Olive Garden.
Yeah, he was on the Joe Rogan message boards back in the day.
So here's what's interesting. I can there's a lot of files here. I can control F. Just tell me what you want to type in. You might find
that
it, boys.
That's crazy.
I'll type in Tom.
Tom and Jerry.
Tom and Jerry, 70. And I'll click on it just to prove it to everybody here. And I'm going to open this now.
God, we really do kick so much ass as a country. Like, our biggest enemies are still watching our shit. Jesus.
I'm sorry.
Jesus Christ.
I'm sorry. God. But that's I'm just proving to the boys that
He really did.
That's so funny to imagine him on LiveWire in like 2007 getting a shit ton of viruses.
Yeah, he was sending emails of himself getting shot to his friends. He's like, look, I'm famous.
Look, he literally has episodes of Tom and Jerry.
Yeah.
He was watching Tom and Jerry.
He's like, that infidel mouse will be punished.
Wow. What else is on there, Ben?
I've only spent a couple days on this website. But I mean, I have no idea what else could be on here. And I'm definitely on some sort of list for downloading so many things.
Oh, sure.
From CIA.gov/library/Abbottabad compound.
Yeah.
He's got ringtones and shit.
Yeah.
He's the kind of guy that wants to chew up on my bubblegum. Chew up on my bubblegum.
Yeah, he's got the My Humps ringtone.
He had a sidekick. He was like, where you at?
He has a rip of Paul Blart. Paul Blart.
Wait,
Mall
does
Cop.
He really?
No, that'd
okay,
be great.
That'd be great.
I really can't believe this is real.
Look, Art of Crochet by Teresa. It's a baby crochet sock edging video.
Dude, he's so gay.
Missile launcher exercises by the Mujahideen.
You're the only guy I know that could do this. That knew about this.
Mm-hmm.
This is insane.
Yeah, supposedly this was his, you know, his private files here on his private computer.
It's like Girls season 5.
I mean, a lot of this is in, would it be in, I'm sorry, boys, I'm kind of ignorant. Is it Arabic?
That looks like Arabic to me. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Whatever they have on Thai food menus, that's what it is.
It does look like Thai actually. Yeah, maybe it might be Thai. I don't know. That's Arabic.
I watched
anything that looks like it's on the Lord of the Rings ring.
Yes,
that
exactly.
Means it's Arabic. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Animal dolphins. This says animal dolphins ring.wmv.
Boy, he really loved dolphins.
Mm-hmm.
What a weirdo.
He was just trying to strap bombs to them.
He's trying to figure out how to train them.
Yeah, look.
We're going to bomb the submarines next, bro. It's going to be crazy.
SeaWorld, very bad. They torture.
They tortured me.
Oh, he just watched. He watched, what is it, Blackfish?
I just watched Blackfish, The Cove, this. I do this for the dolphin.
A big fan of What We Do in the Chateau. Season 5 coming up,
America.
Baby.
They hurt dolphin.
Drop the shadow silk.
Oh, my God.
Oh, that's just a David Attenborough documentary. Dude, that's all. That rules.
Wow.
He was just sitting on a couch with his girl,
just
watching a dolphin documentary about to get some pussy.
This is inspiring me. Like, when I go home tonight, I'm gonna watch like dolphin shit.
We should for a year commit to only watching stuff from.
Maybe every Patreon for the next year, we watch some random video on Osama bin Laden's hard drive.
Oh, I'm saying in my personal life.
Oh, right.
Like,
oh.
I'm hanging out with my girlfriend. She's like, "What do you want to watch tonight?" I'm like, "Let me see." I'm just scrolling
to the Osama bin Laden.
She goes, "What is that?" Is this a friend of mine curated some? Something.
This is my Criterion closet. I'm walking around. It's fucking me and Peter Bogdanovich and go, "Oh, have you ever seen the dolphin documentary? That's actually some of his best work."
Dude, I want to have like a, I wish I had a best of for his.
More dolphin. I keep seeing dolphins.
By the way, I haven't found any porn on there, but I don't know if they legally can have.
I was going to say, I think pornography. I remember, in case I made this up in my head, when he got caught, they released like all the porn that he had. Mm-hmm. They were like, he had Backdoor Butt 7,
and
you
they're
know.
Like, that's why he did 9/11.
Yeah, because of the evils of pornography.
Because of Asa Akira.
He goes, Ava Devine, she's very old now. Gross.
He just Googles, where is Alexis Texas from?
Yeah. He Googles, is Gia Michaels okay? Gina Michaels, excuse me.
Gianna.
Gianna, excuse me, Miss Michaels. My apologies. She'll come in here and kick my ass right now.
She's huge.
She'll kick my ass and suck my dick.
This is, it's really, this makes me feel more and more like it definitely was an inside job because he loves us.
Oh, this, hold on.
this isn't a guy that did 9/11.
Hold on, boys. This says myedgy.com, EGY, and it says Jackie Chan.
Oh, shit. He was like watching the tuxedo. He has Rush Hour on there.
This is great. I'm gonna.
Wait. Oh, it's the Jackie Chan. It's the Jackie Chan TV show.
Oh, that rocks,
dude. That rules,
dude. He had so much good pirated content.
This is insane.
It's like a Japanese translation, or unless this was an anime that was like only in Chinese or something.
I think this was like an American TV show for a while. I mean, but it's translated to Arabic.
Oh,
yeah.
Wasn't he was a billionaire at one point, right? Osama?
Yeah, his family was very rich.
Saudi like billionaires, right?
Yeah. He was also like, what was he, like 6'6"?
He was huge.
He was huge. Yeah. He looked like Scottie Pippen, kind of.
He kind of did look like Scottie Pippen.
Yeah, I would love to see him in the paint with his back to the basket, see what he could do.
Oh, for sure.
Those robes flying around.
Oh, yeah. I'd love to see him, what he does in the bedroom with Larsa.
This says,
Future's also fucking his wife.
Yeah, it's a double team, Future and Osama on Larsa Pippen.
Oh my God, it's an Arabic Toy Story.
Oh my God.
At the end, Buzz flies into the World Trade Center.
Dude, he loved Toy Story.
He was just a sweetheart.
Yeah, you do make a good point. At the end of the day, they hate us. Because, like, they ain't us, basically.
It really is, yeah.
They're still consuming all of our media.
Mm-hmm. He's not even, he's not watching, like, Al Jazeera or anything. Like, none of this is all American shit.
He seems very misinformed, actually. Maybe that's why he did all the shit he did.
Yeah. Yeah, like, he learned it from a Tom and Jerry cartoon. He got radicalized.
He wanted them to bring the old classic cartoon. He's like, once Cartoon Network goes under, it's a useless country. He's going to blow up the whole damn
thing. He goes,
thing.
I heard they canceled MDE.
They do not fund Adult Swim. They need more Space Ghost Coast to Coast. And the one with the big fry who is black. I do not remember the show.
He seems like
Aqua Teen Hunger Force.
That's right. Based on all the stuff he downloaded, he seems like he'd be like a Mighty Boosh guy.
What?
You know what a Mighty... What's a Mighty Boosh again?
It's like the sketch show from England in the 90s that like nerds, like comedy nerds, are like, oh, you never saw the Mighty Boosh?
Okay.
If you're really into like Edgar Wright's early stuff, like Spaced. with Nick Frost and Simon Pegg, you're probably a Mighty Boosh guy. But Mighty Boosh is definitely like Monty. It's in the world of Monty Python, kind of.
It's all those things like comedy nerds, like, you got to check out the Mighty Boosh. And like their biggest sketch is a guy wearing a tiny hat going like, hello. Gotcha.
When it comes to all the goated shit, when it comes to that whole universe, is Darth Marenghi's Dark Place.
Yeah, that's Darth the Marenghi's best Dark Place.
Of all that stuff.
Yeah. I liked that stuff. Mm-hmm. But it's like, yeah, English comedy is that. Monty Python ripoffs, and then a guy just dressing up as an Indian man out of nowhere.
Yeah, and there's also that one guy out there that, like, the Wuthering Heights guy. He's always, I feel like British comedy is the guy, like, he does, like, our version of the Nutty Professor. Like, he dresses up as he plays every character. You guys know what I'm talking about?
Nutty Professor kind of stuff.
You know what Wuthering Heights is?
That
one guy with the he just looks like a Paul Rust kind of like.
Let me open another tab. I don't want to get off the Osama bin Laden website.
In Succession, is that who you're talking about? Tom Wong's scam?
I don't think he's in. No, he's not in Succession. He's like Britain's comedian. He has a sketch show, and the HBO used to push him all the time, and he played like a million characters and shit.
Yeah, I think you're just pulling up.
It says Wuthering Heights is an 1847 novel by Emily Brontë.
Well, never mind. I don't know. Forget it.
I try.
I hate British comedy.
It truly does.
That's why
suck.
I got it wrong.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is a TV show though, Devin.
Well, this is completely off base. This is so far from what I was thinking.
This episode is sponsored by BetterHelp. That's Better HELP. Give online therapy a try at betterhelp.com/lemon and get on your way to being your best self.
Yeah.
Guys, you ever wish life came with a user manual?
All the time.
Yeah, that would be a lot easier if it did.
Well, you know what would be the next best thing?
What could that possibly be?
The next best thing would be betterhelp.com. That's better HELP.com. Because life doesn't come with a user manual. So when it's not working for you, it's normal to feel stuck, which I think we can all relate to.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
feeling
of course.
Stuck.
Yeah.
Navigating any of life's challenges can make you feel unsure, whether it's a career change, a new relationship, or becoming a parent. That's none of us are parents, but all those things have happened to us recently, right, guys?
I've had a career change recently, and I've been extremely chaotic because of it.
And I have a bastard child.
Devin has a child out of wedlock he doesn't talk to.
BetterHelp's helped me a lot.
That's right. BetterHelp has connected over 3 million people with licensed therapists. It's convenient and accessible anywhere and 100% online. Oh, it says here, therapists are trained to help you figure out the cause of challenging emotions and learn productive coping skills, which makes therapy the closest thing to a guided tour of the complex engine called you.
Yeah.
I've been telling you to go to therapy. I've gone to therapy.
I've never gotten therapy, but I'm going to start using BetterHelp.
Yeah.
Well, there's a lot of benefits, self-empowerment, dealing with trauma, etc. If you've benefited from therapy, feel free to speak about that. I think people should have gone to therapy should speak about that, honestly. As the world's largest therapy service, BetterHelp has matched 3 million people with professionally licensed and vetted therapists available 100% online. Plus, it's affordable. Just fill out a brief questionnaire to match with a therapist. If things aren't clicking, you can easily switch to a new therapist anytime. Couldn't be simpler. No waiting rooms, no traffic, no endless searching for the right therapist. Learn more and save 10% off your first month at betterhelp.com/lemon. That's betterhelp.com/lemon. That's betterhelp.com/lemon. But regardless, back to the shooting.
Yes.
They were slut shaming this sex worker.
They were. They were like, he was in Latina slut like that. And I'm like,
well, it's bad. Now it's bad.
What's wrong with that?
Now it's bad to be in porn.
Yeah.
It changes every day.
Every day you can't.
Every day it changes.
Can't get it right.
Mm-hmm. Electric cars are bad now. It's bad to.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, how do you guys feel doing a podcast with a classical lib?
Yeah, you're a classical lib
now.
I'm
a big stinking libtard, apparently.
I can't believe people took all of our tweets that day seriously.
I tweeted the word Elmo Musk, and I lost 800 followers.
Yeah.
You really lost 800 followers?
I think I was like at 49 point something, and now I'm at 48 point something. I think I lost like close to 500 to 800 followers.
Because you guys just went on a we're going to tweet dumb lib shit day, and I wanted to join in, so I just copy-pasted that Jeff Tiedrick ideally the president of Crazy Town.
Yeah. People started messaging me and they're like, hey, don't want to confront your brother about this and embarrass him.
But he's a thief.
He's been stealing jokes from Jeff Tiedrich.
And I put hashtag Trump and like people even comment, they go, I don't understand. The woke mob will tear you to pieces.
Mm-hmm. I'm so confused. What kind of audience are you guys going for? Mm-hmm. If the woke mob finds your show, they're going to rip it to bits.
Like we're doing a podcast where we say just retard and gay slurs.
And then we get online and we're that. It's like astounding the dissociation people
like
have.
Like we're trying to get two very specific types of pussy at one time.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We're just greedy. We're on this podcast like gay, retard, racism. And then we get online and we're like, we stand with the LGBTQ community. Elmo Musk. Drumpf.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. DMing a librarian who weighs 85 pounds.
Mm. Well, that's what's so fucking, that was so funny is like, all we're doing is baiting the culture war. Mm-hmm. And everyone plays into it.
Oh, it's there's so many fish in the sea. You just got to put your line in. And you're like, they're actually, you're like, I didn't even put anything on the hook.
No, it's it's like going to those places where all the fish are starving and you can catch like 800 in an hour. That's what it's like now. You just tweet anything. Just go, well, yeah, this will get a lot of attention. Mm-hmm. And I don't mean it.
Just you tweet Cheeto Drumpf. And they're like, wow. Never thought I'd see the day. The sad
that he turned. The woke mind virus got him. Yeah.
What was that one guy who was like? He was like tweeted some absolutely disgusting stuff about Elon.
Oh yes. Yeah,
really embarrassing.
Some liberal propaganda. I think I just tweeted like Drumpf, Elmo Musk, Cheeto. Like you can just tweet the. They don't really read the tweet.
Mm-hmm. No, they just see the buzzwords. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then people will tweet at you like they're angry at a restaurant. They're like, "Well, you just lost a customer." Mm-hmm. And it's like, "Oh no, I lost the jiu-jitsu coach with 30 followers in Topeka." No, not the guy I didn't know existed until I read this comment.
Oh no, not another guy in his car on the way to some vague crime he's probably committing. Every picture is like the side of the guy's head and he's like holding a steering wheel and you're like, where is he driving? Mm-hmm.
Not another man with a white goatee and matching white Oakleys. Yeah, not a man whose face is bright red from all the ED pills he's been taking for decades.
Just a guy who's a domestic abuser because he's not smart enough to understand what people are saying to him. So he just starts swinging wildly. He has no idea what's going on. Mm-hmm. And so his wife just gets haymaker after haymaker. Mm-hmm. He's like, I told you I don't understand what people are saying.
Yeah, he's in the street like, I can't read.
Everybody, all those people in my head are like Chris Farley and Billy Madison. Mm-hmm. They have, right? Isn't that the mutton chops?
The bus driver, yeah.
Just barely hanging on.
Yeah, yeah. Just like snapping at a moment's notice. Like you'll be having, because I do know some people like that in my real life, and you'll just, like everybody, it'll be a family get together, they'll be having a nice day, all of a sudden they'll be like, if you let the puppy in the living room, it'll shit everywhere. And all of a sudden people are just screaming at each other, you're like, what the, god damn it.
Yeah, the types of families that they talk to the dogs. They go, god damn it, Harley. What are you doing to an animal?
Yeah.
To an animal.
They literally go walk up to the dog. They go, why would you shit in the living room? I'm so disappointed in you right now. And the dog is, this is Chinese.
Yeah.
You're speaking right now.
People calling their dog a liberal cuck.
I barely looked into the shooting. Saw the, some people said he is a non-binary guy or something.
His head is fully flat on the back.
Oh, really?
I don't know if you saw it.
He's like in a pencil top.
Yeah, he has a big fat head, but the back of his head is like a 90 degree angle.
Is that how he gets around the house? He just lays on his back and kicks?
Yeah, like a slug.
Well, I looked into it. The hypothesis online is that he was left at his crib for like his whole life.
And his head just kind of melted?
It's like a diagnosis. There's a name for it. It's called like some bullshit. Mm-hmm. And it's when a kid is just left alone and never let out of his fucking crib.
His head grows.
His head deformed into a flat shape.
Their head is like when you put a watermelon in a cinder block, so it grows into a square. But that's for like a person.
Yeah, it would be weird if like he was left in the crib so long, it's like how a tree grows through a house.
Yeah.
Like he just grew into the crib and just is walking around.
He's shaped like the word Mississippi. Yeah, he probably was left in the crib because his dad was just on meth, like shooting porn scenes.
Yeah,
like in the next room.
He was the gay club.
Those people were in his like belly. I'm sorry.
That's sorry. Good. Sorry. That's no, it's, good. It's an American tragedy.
But you know, I'm sure one happened. Oh, right now, another one happened.
Yeah, it is. Every it is. That's the funny thing about shooting, and it's very funny. One of the funniest things. The funniest thing, because it's all everything.
There's many funny things about shooting.
Everything that happens at a shooting is funny.
But what's
to me.
The funniest thing? About
the
it?
Funniest thing is that people like. There's so many shootings in America. You can just like. It's almost like a game of like oh, that game where you're in the pool and you have to swim across and not get caught, like sharks and minnows.
Yeah.
Like everybody just waits until it's their people who get shot up, and then they get to have the week where they're like, well, this is clearly targeting my group of people. And it's like, well, just wait a week, and then it's going to be, fucking Chinese guy shot a bunch of Mexican guys in sombreros.
Yep. Right. It's all used politically, and nobody, you know, none of the tragedies are actually thought about.
Right.
Longer than a week.
Yeah, like 2 years ago, there was the Asian jerk-off place shooting, and everybody was up in arms, and then like a day later, that black guy drove over like 20 white children in Kenosha, and it's just funny to see people like taking turns on either side of that.
You're supposed to politicize the shooting if it works for your political thing.
And then if it doesn't, you just stay silent, you go sad.
You go, can't believe someone would politicize this.
Yeah, you go, can't believe someone would delete all your tweets from a week ago.
People just type into Google, is the shooter today gay? And if it just Google comes up with no, and you're a Republican, then you don't politicize it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. If it comes back yes and you're a Republican, then you politicize it.
Yeah.
And vice versa if you're a Democrat.
There's always like the first 2 hours of a shooting where everybody's kind of like, all right, like they're all like waiting by the side for the picture to get released. And then just like five people like dive on top of it. It's like musical chairs for shooting.
It's so sick.
Yeah.
It's been this way. I mean,
it'll be a black guy, but they're like, but he was in the KKK. And everybody's like, there's nothing we can do with this.
Can't do anything with that. Hide it.
Damn it.
Hide the news.
Hide that one.
That's not news today.
Well, I guess the bright side is eventually we'll all be killed.
That was what was amazing about the Thousand Oaks shooter who got like 14 people in that bar.
Yeah.
I didn't even know about this.
This was maybe 3 years ago.
Years ago. It was a ex-army guy, weirdly enough. A guy who was in the armed forces. I thought he was trying to protect and serve.
Mm-hmm.
But he opened fire in this bar, weirdly.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway. I guess it was just a freak thing that
one time.
His career and his service has nothing to do with him shooting up this bar, obviously. Yeah. But the people at the bar were meeting together. They were survivors of the Vegas shooting a year prior.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
They were literally having like a reunion get together, like, hey, how's everybody? And then they just got shot.
Like at the end, they're like, well, we can all be thankful that the odds of us being in another shooting ever again for the rest of our lives will probably statistically never happen.
Yeah.
That type of shit makes me think everything's fake. Just because what are the... if there is a God, how does God greet those people?
Yeah.
I don't know, man.
It would be great if you got to Kevin. God's like, yeah, I did that shit. What are you going to fucking do about it, dude?
He's just laughing like Jim Carrey in Dumb and Dumber when the guy's joking. They get up to heaven and he's just like, ha! This is a demon. Yeah, I mean, God is a demon, right? If he does exist.
But no, like, you literally are in heaven. He's like, what are you going to do? Go to hell? Suck my fucking dick.
You're lucky to be here, bitch.
God's like taking a shit. He's smoking weed. He's like, fuck you.
You're a part of history, fag.
God smoking
weed. He's wiping
weed
from the front.
God smoking weed out of a Coke can. He's getting fucking aluminum poisoning. And he goes, fucking suck my dick, dude. No, if you want to get into heaven right now, I swear to God, suck my fucking dick.
Suck my dick.
Because of my Christian upbringing, by the way, I'm like, oh, is he going to kill me now?
Yeah.
Like, I feel like if I mock him in any way, he's going to do something. He's going to... Now I have cancer. It's behind my eye.
Right.
And it's going to start going to my brain now because I said that.
I always think, like, if I ever have kids, they're going to be, like, retarded for sure.
Why?
Because I've just said the word... I said the word retarded.
Right. He's going to curse you. Yeah. I don't know.
Or gift me.
Mm-hmm. Or gift you. Right.
With these beautiful...
Be a bundle of slobber.
Gift me with these children who statistically cost $2 million more to raise.
you have a retarded kid, you just take him home in a box like it's a puppy.
That's such a brutal way to put it.
Because of all the medical care?
Yeah, congratulations, like, it's a $2 million bill.
Mm. So anyway, the helmets are like $500, and they're going to grow out of it every 6 weeks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And you got to find the type of shoes for them, because their head is on their feet.
Your car is going to have to be like a Transformers type of car, unfortunately, now. That's going to cost $80,000 to rig up.
Oh, and just
you have to you have to tie him like he's like you have to nail him to a cross inside your SUV to go anywhere.
You have to put him on the thing from Mad Max with the guitar player. He's like, yeah. But he can riff like shit, dude. It's fucking cool.
God bless anyone that has to.
Oh, it's very. I have friends who's like
me too.
One of my best friends, his brother's severely mentally disabled. It's his family will honestly be like, it's been a horrific burden, mm-hmm. but you know we do love him. But
sure,
yeah,
God, you know.
No, I mean it's a tragedy. It is. I'm not even. I just can't. I never sound sincere anymore because we've ruined our lives with talking and jokes. Mm-hmm. So.
Yeah, it was funny. I was like at a barbecue this week. Everybody's like, "Hey, love the retarded racist podcast you guys do. It's great." Everybody's telling me how they have to turn it down anytime respectable people come near them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I've gotten that a few times too.
Yeah.
My friend Kevin was listening to it, and his baby was in the room, and he had to put earphones in just because he's like, it might have an effect on the baby. It's like 4 months old.
Like playing music for a plant, like Mozart for.
Yeah, we just left this guy in a crib and we played O&A for a couple years and now he thinks he's from Boston.
He shot up a gay club.
But you know, you gotta laugh.
You gotta laugh. You gotta,
we do so much good. I love the comics who spend it like this. No, this is good for. It's not good. It's just fun.
Yeah.
You know?
So the shooter was non-binary and had like an Easter Island head.
Did he just say he was non-binary to like fuck with the cops again? Kind of like Ezra Miller did?
Yeah, maybe.
Oh, maybe, yeah.
Or maybe he's not smart enough to do that. Maybe he genuinely is non-binary.
I don't. Dude, all of them look like Brendan Dassey to me. I have no idea. I don't know if I'm seeing the same guy. I don't know if the same guy just keeps getting out and doing the shooting
again. I think so. Well, remember, I think we one of our first episodes, I said I feel like I see the same retarded guy like everywhere I go. I feel same like with it's the same with shooters.
Well, like he's a CIA operative. Or at the very, he's been following you.
At the very least, they all have the same barber.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Which is themselves.
Dude, you know what's funny? I've been cutting my own hair for like a year.
Yeah.
I can never tell.
That is the first step, I guess, in being one of those guys.
Yeah.
You have to cut your own hair.
Yeah. You're taken
out of the car. It is like removing yourself one more step from society than you need to.
It really is. Yeah. That I'm not allowing other members of society to groom me in any way.
Mm-hmm.
And I set my own standards for grooming.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like the next step of that is like being like, no more llamas for me. I'm a scythe guy.
Mm.
I got a big metal sword.
It
I
is
cut
the
my
first step
with.
In breaking away from society while remaining in society. Like, mm-hmm. that's your version of Into the Wild. You're like, I'm going to cut my own hair and start. Maybe I'll grow some tomatoes.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to save $40 a month, which does feel great, actually.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But you're just walking in with big chunks out of your head. You're bleeding on your ear, and you're like, I just saved $25.
Yeah. But in your mind, you're walking around like, I'm like Sitting Bull.
Yeah, you're playing shitty Eddie Vedder music.
Exactly. You're cutting your own hair.
Yeah, cutting your hair and going, fuck you, mom. Fuck you, dad. I'm going to eat some berries and die. Like an asshole. Like
I hate that guy.
I'm going to take pictures of me when I'm really skinny, but I'm going to be happy about it.
That scene when he burns the money in that movie is so infuriating.
Yeah, it's the money and all his IDs and everything.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alexander Supertrampkin. I'm glad he's dead.
Me too. Yeah. Fucking retard. He also didn't even bother walking up the river a little bit to see if maybe there was a part he could cross.
Yeah, just have a map, idiot.
Moron.
I don't know what you guys are talking about because I have a YouTube premium subscription. So my life, I'm just never going to watch anything ever again.
I think YouTube premium is the only thing worth buying.
It. Yeah.
It's worth, I'll say, I think it's worth like $30 a month.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It's that good.
It's amazing. It changed my whole life.
Because for me, yeah, it's like, do I want to watch 900 ads a day or give YouTube $10?
Yeah.
I'm like, I think it's worth $10.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's the only thing I pay for where I'm like, this is worth it.
Mm.
Pretty soon we'll all be like in a bread line, but we'll all have YouTube Premium.
It's also like you're free of the insult of having ads tailored to you in your Google searches.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Where it's just like, I cannot for the life of me get rid of the fat guy t-shirt ads. And it hurts my feelings every time.
What's the fat guy t-shirt
it's
ad?
Literally, you see, you would never know. It's it's literally like an ad. It's a guy who looks like I'm looking in a mirror, but it's on my phone. And it's a guy going like, are you tired of your t-shirt showing your titties to people? Buy fat guy t-shirts. So you too can get pussy at this freak. You freak. Fuck you. Buy the t-shirt, faggot. Sorry.
I've seen those. The big dog t-shirts and yeah. shit too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I should start doing big dog t-shirts.
You should just be a big dog guy.
Get really into barbecuing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm always wearing the black gloves everywhere.
with the fingerless.
No, I mean the guys who get really into barbecue, they put black surgical gloves on.
Oh yeah, I've seen that. That's a new thing. People eat wings and shit with those now too. I've seen.
Really?
You ever gone to a wing place and they give you gloves?
People are putting on tactical gear.
It just makes the guy that makes them. He makes them feel like Walter White with wings or something. It's completely retarded.
Yeah.
It sucks ass. I hate it.
He's got teriyaki sauce and a Bunsen burner.
Dude, he's going to like Big Five Sporting Goods so he can go to Buffalo Wild Wings after. He's getting all the gear.
Yeah, he's wearing a catcher's vest and a visor.
I've only seen it with like these like...
I hate that so much.
It's those Armenian guys that do it in Glendale, like those Armenian pop-ups for like hot chicken and wings and stuff.
Yeah, people are going in with like mouth guards.
Yeah. I don't know. Armenian guys are obsessed with like Southern fried chicken and selling it.
Mm.
And then like doing
it's very alpha, I think, is why.
Chicken.
I think it's super alpha.
Yeah, it's like the alpha because cooking is kind of gay naturally. So you have to be like, no, I make fucking none of my shit tastes good. It hurts your mouth when you eat it. Because I'm fucking alpha, dude.
Everything they eat has to have a flame sticker on it.
Yeah, it's called, like, beat your mama, like retard sauce.
Yeah. Beat your mama retard sauce. Those places where they stamp the bun on your burger with the logo. Have you been to one of those?
No, I haven't seen those. It's a cow, they brand it?
Yeah, they brand your burger with the logo of, like, it's a smash burger.
Yeah, it just says not gay on it.
Totally straight.
Totally straight.
Dude, you come into our restaurant, we're playing Saving Private Ryan on every screen.
But yeah, the Colorado shooter was taken down.
Yeah.
Yeah, good.
By an ex-Marine. So that goes against what you said, but the ex-Marine stopped him this time.
What, this guy wasn't let into the Marines? Is that what you said?
No, I think the guy that killed stopped the Colorado shooter.
So he didn't shoot himself, he was shot by an ex-Marine.
I think the guy's alive, the shooter.
Oh, really? Mm. He just took him down?
I think he just took him down and started beating him.
Yeah, they beat the shit out of him.
Hell yeah.
He beat the shit out of him in his boots.
That honestly rules.
He has a mugshot where his head is... they're like, oh, is his head misshapen now? Because they're like, no, he's just born.
That was him.
They just born like that.
Yeah.
He just looked like this.
Yeah, they're like, they beat him so hard his head went flat on the back.
Because someone beat him with a pistol whipped him.
Really?
They put him on the ground. They kept hitting him with the butt of the gun until so his face is totally black and green.
That honestly rules.
Yeah.
I would love if they just gave him a wedgie and then all pissed on him.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Gave him monkeypox.
Yeah, they just they go, is there a gay gentleman here to have sex with him real quick?
Mm-hmm.
His dad was in Intervention, too, the show.
Oh, really?
He has a whole episode, his dad. Yeah, where he's doing math and jacking off for 12 hours straight.
I did see that. Yeah, I saw that and I went, huh.
Mm-hmm.
I just kept scrolling.
Kept moving.
I went totally normal.
Well, when I saw it, I go, that guy is the father of a shooter.
I saw the whole interview, too, where he said... he's like, thank God my boy's not gay, basically.
Yeah.
And everybody was like, well, this honorable man is just tarnished.
They're like, this
his
is
legacy.
Typical MAGA qualities.
You know what? If I have a school shooter, I hope he's gay. Yeah, not focusing on the right thing whatsoever. And it just rules that these guys control all national discourse.
Mm-hmm.
Just guys who came out of the high fructose corn syrup factory. Just in fucking Cincinnati
somewhere.
They dictate
the direction of our country.
Yeah, guys who've been living off Doritos and Four Loko for decades.
Dude, it would be funny to raise your son. You're like, I'm going to raise my son to, because school shooter's like kind of the default now.
Sure.
So you have to just raise your son.
It's like you can become an EMT, a soldier, or a school shooter.
Yeah. It's like when you take the test in high school, it says... it's a garbage truck driver, school shooter.
Pretty soon the government will fund your college if you shoot at the school.
You get a scholarship, to shoot up your own college.
They're gonna start taking those guys and just sending them to school in like United Arab Emirates.
Sure.
Like, yeah, son, sure. Do us proud.
Do us proud. You just have to raise your child to shoot up the thing you don't like.
Yeah, exactly.
Like, he's just gonna. He's there.
It's an unstoppable. We're never gonna stop it. So you just gotta like harness that energy to something positive.
That's the whole thing in Blood Meridian, is that from a young age within the boy is the need
to
shoot up
a school,
the want to kill, basically the hunger for war and murder.
Sure. It's in his blood.
It's in his blood, essentially.
Yeah.
So you just have to train. Like, are they going to shoot up an NRA convention? And then, you know, Ethan and Hila Klein are, like, you know, twerking.
Sure.
Like, woo!
That would throw a big wrench in things.
It would throw a huge wrench.
If a pacifist shot up an NRA convention, but, like, because Jesus had to.
Well, yeah. Ethan said on his show.
That would Tucker Carlson's head would just explode.
What would happen?
Him and Rachel Maddow would start fucking.
We break the simulation. We're all like, we're free! Like, these beams of light hit everybody. We all ascend.
Look, it's like, congrats, you're in Tokyo in the year 3589. And we're like, ah, shit, we're Chinese? Fuck! Send me back.
Oh, fuck. What were you saying? Ethan Klein and Hila?
They got a strike on YouTube because they told their fans to bomb an NRA convention in Houston.
Mm-hmm.
Whoa. And they got, like, taken down.
Yeah.
I think Ethan was like, that was my bad.
But it is regardless. Technically a call for mass violence.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is not great.
But I mean,
those two suck a lot of ass. And I know you might have met them, but I hate both of them every time I see them on YouTube. Anyway.
Yeah.
Yep.
Don't get it.
Don't
whatsoever.
Get it
whatsoever.
Liked the Vape Nation video? That was 14 years ago. Make something else funny.
Yeah, you're talking about him like he's a director who died two decades ago.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Like he's fucking, Francis Ford Coppola. I'm like, yeah, the Vineyards are great, but like, let's make another masterpiece. But I do love
we would only be so lucky to retire from comedy one day and then finally become comedians.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even respect what we do here because we don't.
Because we don't do stand-up.
We're not stand-ups. I'd rather be one of those stand-ups that like has a podcast and doesn't do any jokes. And then people would be like, well, they're respect. I respect the shit out of them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We just talk about the art of doing stand-up.
We got to start making a lot of money, though, so we can afford the wardrobe.
Right, the shoes,
the
ripped jeans.
The hats. Yeah, it would be fun if we started doing the podcast. We're all wearing the Lumineers hats. The Clint Eastwood.
I know what you're talking about.
The Clint Eastwood hats.
Yeah, the Zorro hats.
Yeah, we're all just turned like huge feathers coming out of them. We slowly all start dressing like old cowboys. I have spurs and a six shooter.
We all look like Civil War reenactors.
You look like trans Sam Elliott, essentially.
Yeah, and I'm like, oh, don't mind me. I'm about to go to get some sushi in Beverly Hills. But I'm dressed like I'm about to like shoot up an old Mexican town.
I'm dressed like P.T. Barnum.
Yeah, we dress like we're in like the Dirty Dozen.
Yeah.
Ben, we got to start making more money so we could build a studio that makes people think we have a product.
Yeah. Let's make a studio that when people see it, they go, wow, I'm suddenly nauseous. When women see the studio, they have to go take a pregnancy test to see if they have morning sickness.
My favorite podcasts are filmed inside a QVC. Anyway. Yeah. I was going to say, even like the guy, like these mentally challenged people control our national discourse. There was that guy, I don't think we talked about that woodshop teacher in Canada.
The tits?
Who had the huge fake silicone tits.
Yeah.
And then, you know, like Carlson and Maddow are arguing about him for fucking weeks. And it turns out he was just a troll.
It was a prank.
Yeah. He's a prank. It was Johnny Knoxville.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like if Rachel Maddow was like, should Baba Booey eat Howard Stern's asshole?
Yeah, Tucker just being like, we should be able to get on the Sibian. Why can't Carmen Electra sit on the Sibian and get her pussy ate by a little robot?
Oh, God.
Yeah, I was really into the Sibian. Once we hit it rich, I'm just buying Sibians for my entire apartment.
We do have to have a Sibian in here at some point.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It would be great if you have this nice Katie decorated place and your like one contribution is a Sibian just in like the dining room.
Now what's that again?
It's the big, it's like a big half cylinder thing with a little vibrating.
Yeah, women just, you sit on them and come. Right. Fuck you.
That's
yeah.
what I,
it's a fuck machine.
I was being very fancy about it.
I confuse that with a theremin, which is a totally other thing. But to me, anybody that...
I would love to see those combined, though.
A theremin and a Sibian
and
combined.
A Sibian.
What's a theremin?
It's the one where you wave your hand. It's like...
You put like a magnet over a little magical box.
Okay.
That the devil made. And it just makes crazy noises because of magnetic stuff.
Got you. Okay.
Mm. And assholes play it. Like right. You have to be a real cunt.
Yeah.
Oh, it's one of the...
To play a theremin.
It's... Okay. Gotcha.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you have one of those, you like you drive a Polaris slingshot.
Yeah. It's a guy.
You have the Daft Punk helmet and you're driving a Polaris slingshot. You know what a Polaris slingshot is?
No.
It's those three-wheeled motorcycles that suck ass.
Oh, I hate that shit.
With the two wheels in the front and the one in the back.
That those retards pull up to the comedy store in sometimes and shit.
Dude, I really want a Polaris slingshot because it might be the worst thing you and I saw they're only like $20,000. I'm like, maybe really? I should maybe I should just lease one.
They're either for guys who are too fat to ride their motorcycle anymore or like guys who want to like be in Tron, basically.
Yeah.
They like want a light bike. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I see them a lot in like Beverly Hills and shit.
Yeah, they really suck ass.
They're horrible cars.
One of the worst things you could ever own. And guys that own them own like 9 different colors.
It's just a fuckboy's version of a penny farthing bicycle. That like a hipster would be driving in like Silver Lake.
It is. Yeah.
It's the same thing.
Any guy that would have a twisty, evil villain mustache on the other end of the spectrum
is a guy with a vape and joggers and he's in his whatever this thing's called.
Yeah, if you made an M. Night Shyamalan movie where on one side was the hipster cuck guy and then where it's like Unbreakable, where it's like on one side is the guy with the what is it, penny farthing? That's the one with the giant wheel.
Yeah,
the giant wheel
on the
you
front.
You have to get lifted up onto it. You have to have a buddy with you.
No, you have to climb on top of your top hat and then put yourself on the and then get on the bike.
And then hope your IPAs don't break.
Right. You have to sit on a man's cock to get on top of the bicycle. That's how gay it is.
Dude, imagine if we all had matching Polaris slingshots and we drove them to the shooting range together.
Oh, that'd be
like
great.
Like we're in Wild Hogs.
Like one last ride.
Yeah, one last ride, boys.
And then the Polaris slingshot. Yeah.
We rev it up and it's just like...
People, it's funny that people are like, these are the best. People that love them are like in a club. And they're like, the Polaris slingshot is the best motorcycle. And it's like, if it's the best motorcycle, why does no one else make anything like it?
Right.
They're the only... Yeah. Polaris is like, I think there's a void in the market here for people who are absolutely retarded and completely worthless. Like, we need to start pumping these out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They look horrible. It's a tricycle
but
for rapists.
But people buy them. It's a...
When you get out of jail for raping, that just pulls up.
It's
and
for,
you hop in.
It's for a 6-year-old rapist. A 6-year-old with a goatee.
Mm. It's something so retarded, it's not even like in Mario Kart.
Right.
It's way too fucking stupid.
If you pull that up to Rainbow Road, they would gay bash you in Mario Kart. Donkey Kong would curb stomp you right next to your Polaris slingshot.
Wario calls you gay.
Yeah, Wario, yeah, you're gay.
Mm-hmm.
If we had those things, we would have to like customize them with like they make like our horns make custom like early internet noises.
Yeah.
Like, so mine goes like bada bing bang 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 bang.
Oh, the crazy frog ring tone.
And then like Ben's goes like, "Welcome to Burger King. Can I take your order? Welcome."
Ding fries are done. Ding fries are done. Ding fries are done. Jason just makes the Peter Griffin laugh.
Yeah. I rev mine. It goes freaking sweet. At like, but like 40 decibels. Mm. A freaking sweet so loud it like it deafens a baby.
Yeah. I cut someone off and just go, "Victory's mine."
Yeah, you would be driving around throwing banana peels out the back of it.
Resistance is futile.
Dude, what is stopping us from getting a Polaris slingshot now?
They're only $20,000. I mean,
that is a lot of money.
I won't be buying one, but
I asked Katie if I could buy one a couple months ago and she said no.
What do they get gas wise?
Oh, good. Like let's see if they are realistic.
It would be funny if they're like, you know, like 12 miles to the gallon. It has no benefit.
Yeah, it probably is 12.
It really is like talking your wife into letting you buy one of these is like convincing her to put all your savings in Bitcoin. It's the same conversation.
You ask Kate, can I buy a Polaris Slingshot? She's like, can you just cheat on me?
It's the Dumb and Dumber dog car for like Instagram influencers. Look at that stupid piece of shit.
Oh my God. It's so bad.
Get a motorcycle like a real man, you fucking idiots.
Get your head cut off in a vicious traffic accident.
I'm like,
moron.
Babe, it's safer. It's safe.
Babe, it's safe. There's no top or sides. Yeah, it has all the dangers of a motorcycle, but none of the having sex with women.
You're completely out in the open if you drive this thing.
I'm trying to find the MPG on this bad boy. God, it doesn't... God, why can I never find
it? It probably doesn't even run on gas. You have to use your feet like the Flintstones.
Yeah, it does have pedals.
It has pedals.
28 miles per gallon.
My car gets more than
23 to 33, and it has a capacity of 9 gallons.
Well, at least if it starts raining, you know, you have a nice drive home.
Dude, imagine...
And you can only get to, like, Riverside and back with it.
Imagine you're going to, like you're talking to a guy at the bar, and you're like, all right, he's kind of like, you know, he doesn't have the quite the things I'm looking for in a man, but what the hell?
It's a lonely, it's a lonely Friday night.
He's good looking enough. Mm-hmm. He's told a few good anecdotes. You're like... And then he asks you, you know, hey, you want to come back, you know, watch a movie or whatever? Maybe we have another drink at my place. Nothing too pushy. Mm-hmm. Like, all right. You're like, I've had too much to drink. Can I go home with you? He's like, sure. You walk out. You see him grab a motorcycle helmet. And you're like, not really.
You're like, ooh, a bad boy.
A bad boy.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Who is this, the Fonz? And then you kind of, as a woman, you start getting kind of into it. Mm-hmm. You're like, oh, I'm gonna maybe it'll be like
the danger. I shouldn't be riding this.
He's really cool. Like at one of those movies where you're like in Paris mm-hmm. as a woman, you're riding on the back of a model's motorcycle to the cities of Paris.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
it's amazing. Like all these fantasies start going, and you walk outside. It's that fucking retarded.
Yeah,
piece of shit.
He hands you a helmet with a propeller on the top of it. He goes, no, wear these goggles. They're for my dog, but they should fit your face.
And you go home with them anyway because the last drink he gave you made you really tired.
Oh, God. I was in New York once and I saw a bunch of these guys riding them together as if they were in a gang. And they were revving their engine.
Yeah, it was Meek Mill.
That's an East Coast thing, but I didn't think that they would go for these stupid things.
Well, I know black guys in New York ride like fucking motocross bikes and shit.
Yeah, like in Philly and Baltimore and shit.
That's cool.
It's very cool.
Because you're like, oh, is that Blade? I don't know.
Exactly. It's like, is that a black vampire?
Because that's black people are so intrinsically cool they can be like emo and you're like that rules.
That kicks ass. They can do anything.
Like Kid Cudi's like, I wanna kill myself. You're like, fuck yeah.
Yeah. Your white friend Darren's like, I wanna kill myself. You're like, get it together, fag.
Listen to Kid Cudi. He knows what he's talking about.
Day and night.
The Lord is done, the sea to free in mind at night. I'm gonna fucking kill myself.
I'm not gonna learn this thing.
What?
I'm gonna learn this thing too. I'm not Kid Cudi.
I have no arms.
You're just a torso.
I love a torso that's like, I love smoking kish.
Have you guys heard Ted Teddy?
And the bottom of your torso has this hollowed out area that Katie just inserts you on the chair like a beach umbrella.
Oh, to hold me in place, essentially.
So you just shake a huge rod.
I see what you're saying.
You have a rod up your back all the time.
I asked you to free my man, didn't I? I'm going to keep moving on.
Oh, God.
R.I.P. Juice WRLD.
There is. That reminds me of my favorite. There's two guys on TikTok I love, and they're both like inspirational guys. But one guy has no lower body. Mm-hmm. He has one of those where his what?
What was that?
I think just your chair moving shit around.
I thought. Okay, sorry.
I didn't hear anything.
I thought someone was scratching at the door.
Yeah,
I thought it was.
It's that shooter's dad coming to kill us. He bursts in and fucks all of us and then shoots us. Just this messed out monster.
After he zips his pants up, he goes, "I ain't no queer," and he blows our heads off.
No, my favorite is this guy is being like, "You can do anything you want, kids. Like, here's how I go through my day." And but the thing is, he has no lower body, but it's so high up. Like, it's like, I swear to God, it's like right here.
Oh my God, like just below his heart and lungs.
He looks like a head with, he looks like Mike Wachowski from Monsters, Inc. But without the feet. And this is we know this is the meanest podcast of all time. We're aware.
He looks like Mike Wachowski. I haven't thought about Mike Wachowski in like a decade.
But so he walks around and he posts, he's like, "Here's how I do the dishes." And he's like hopping up on the counter. But every single comment is like, "Dude, where is your dick and balls?" And every month or so, he'll post a long video like, "I've explained that I have a penis and testicles." And he goes, "It's like any normal person." And but what he doesn't get is people are like, "But it should be here. Like, how is it up here?" But he won't explain that at all. He'll just be like, "I just wear a diaper so I can just crawl around on my hands."
But there's just one big question they all want him to answer.
Yeah, they literally just want him to go like, "Dude, your body stops here. Like, how is there a dick here?
Like, where does he pee?
Do you have a dick in your chest? Like, just show it to us, like, one time, and we'll stop asking."
Do you think he shits out of his chest?
He maybe shits out of his mouth, like Cartman. I don't know. He seems like a very nice guy. Also gay, which is kind of funny, but it doesn't matter.
Oh, is he the TikTok guy?
He's the TikTok guy.
Yeah, who always goes viral.
Oh, he's gay, too?
There's another one. I think this is the one Ben's thinking of, where it's a guy who's just a pillowcase. He has no... just a torso and a head, but he's a very flamboyant.
No arms, but he can somehow get around, and no legs.
Huh?
And he just sort of like, he can just sort of whip himself into the. Yeah. It's kind of wild. No,
it's kind of wild. He'll just be laying in bed. He's like, "Oh, I got to get up," and it'll just like whip him. He'll whip his whole torso like across like against the wall and fall down.
Like he's telekinetic. He can just almost. Move. He looks matter.
Like he's a veggie tail.
Yeah,
like he can just kind of hop around and shit.
But he walks like a South Park character.
Okay. Oh my God.
Sorry. Sorry.
It's amazing that he's can do all these. But he doesn't really need to tie his shoes. He doesn't have any feet. So,
yeah.
I mean,
yeah, at least there's a few things that are easier for him.
But he loves to dance, and he's always posting about how he loves dance. But it's just him like spinning around on one of his corners. Like if he took a DVD case and spun it.
He can only spin.
Yeah, it's like Chandelier by Sia is playing, and he's like, just like kind of wiggling around.
So he tries to do all the viral TikTok dances.
Yeah.
Where you know there's a viral TikTok dance and everybody does the dance. Yeah. Where he's doing it, and you're watching him do it, and you're like, okay, I can imagine what your arms and legs should be doing,
right.
But they're not there.
Mm-hmm.
So technically, I guess you did the dance, I guess, even though you kind of just did this.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah, no hate on him. The funny thing to me is that every, like, you know, because you'll post a video on TikTok and then, like, it just random shot where the algorithm takes you. So half of his videos will take him to, like, gay TikTok. Everybody's like, hero, queen, slay, go off. And then half of his videos I've seen will just go to, like, fucking Southern Christian TikTok. And they're like, what the hell? Did being gay do this to you? Is this the monkeypox?
Is that Gollum?
Because he looks like a mascot's head.
Right, like just the head.
Just the mascot's head. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And he gets around off. It sounds like pure will is how he walks.
Yeah, it's sheer tyranny of will.
Just will gets him to... Interesting.
And I mean, honestly, credit to both these people because I would kill myself like first day.
Sure.
If you just dropped me into that body. Mm-hmm. I would just,
It is amazing.
Yeah. I would just jump in like the garbage disposal or something. Mm-hmm. Just like take me out.
The will to live is incredible
with
these torsos you guys are mentioning.
Also, I would like first day try to put on my shoes or something, or I guess they don't have shoes. I try to brush my teeth and I knock my head. Like into the light switch and start an electrical fire, I would just burn alive in my home immediately. I'd get crushed by a TV.
Mm-hmm.
Do you remember that old bit we were doing where it was. You get crushed. crushed by the TV. What, a TV from
the 90s? I'm trying to turn it on and it falls off.
Trying to turn it on with your forehead.
Yeah, a tube.
Just bashing your head into the TV.
Your grandma's TV with tubes in it and shit.
Oh, God.
A dog just picks me up and carries me out. Yeah. Carries me out the front door.
I go hiking and an eagle takes me. I'm screaming for my friends, goodbye forever.
It's funny to look like a minion, though. It is. It's like he's the shape of a minion.
Yeah, it is very.
Do you think
is,
that's where these animators like came up with these things, like minions and
Mike Wachowski?
They were just they were looking at freaks. Not freaks. I don't know. Nah. What do we call them? Deformed people.
Differently abled.
Different abled?
Individuals.
Yep.
Handicapped.
But like severely handicapped.
It's like really bad.
I think it's just
disabled.
Yeah.
I love anybody who's like having to go through this and then like them. Like I watched this documentary on like a basketball coach who's a little person. And he just talks about how he gets through he's like a finance guy. So he puts on a little Gordon Gekko suit.
Yeah.
And makes like $200,000 and then go coaches like a New Jersey basketball team. But it's just funny because he's, you know, he's tiny.
Yeah. That's nothing wrong with that.
He's a little guy.
It's like, yeah, there's all those shows. I think on TLC. TLC just has shows like, it's the torsos.
There's a video of this
guy. And it's
a
whole family of torsos.
Of just thumbs.
Thumbs. It's the thumb family.
Dude, there's a viral video of the guy we're talking about where he gets married and he's in the wedding gown, though. And he's walking
down. Yeah, the pillowcase guy.
The pillowcase guy, he's in a wedding gown.
Yeah.
It's insane because I've stubbed my toe and wanted to kill myself before because of the pain. Like, little bits of pain make me want to be like, I don't want to ever feel that again. I can't imagine.
If I get out of my car and I drop my phone and the case breaks, I'm like, if I had a gun, I'd blow my brains out right now. It's like, I can only imagine the day you can't get the grilled cheese cooked because you have no arms.
My biggest night, if I lost my wallet, I might just get out on the 405 and walk in front of a truck.
Yeah, the last time I've only lost my wallet once, but I literally laid in my bed. And I go, why has God done this to me? Of all people, what have I done? And then I just laid there for 2 hours before I went about fixing anything. I didn't even shut my card off. I'm like, take it. I don't care. Take all my money. I'll fucking kill myself.
Take it.
Yeah, can you imagine? If I lost one arm, let alone every single appendage.
I've told you guys about my friend Neil, who's a paraplegic, and he was a depressed, like already like a dark like screenwriter.
Mm-hmm. He wrote hit movies.
He wrote River's Edge, the famous cult classic with Keanu Reeves and Dennis Hopper and shit.
Sure.
And then like right the year before that got made, he paralyzed himself. So his whole
waist down.
Yeah. So his whole, career was clouded with, he was like a 6'4 dude that was about to make it and take off. And then I just saw him go into a massive depression where he just sits in a hospital bed all day and watches TV. But even him already being depressed, like he still cares enough to watch The Soprano, you know?
Yeah.
Like if one thing happened to me, I don't know if I'd be able to keep.
Yeah,
caring.
Sure.
I'm already so depressed sometimes.
We talked about this. I would be a huge asshole about it. Like you guys would try to get me to hang out. I'd be like, yeah, no, let's go to the park. I can't walk because I don't have legs. Asshole, even give a shit about me. I'd become a massive diva.
Yeah, I think if I became horribly disabled, I'd be you kind of have to be a narcissist.
Yeah,
because you can't think about others.
I'd be at the super. We talked about this. I'd be at the supermarket just cutting people off at like the checkout line and be like, "No, come on, say something. I dare you.
I dare you.
I dare you. My face is hanging off from a grizzly attack. I dare you to say something."
Go ahead, call me a pillow tard. Go ahead. No, I'm filming. I'm filming. Go ahead.
Yeah, I just always have a body cam on me. No. Go ahead. Yell at me real quick.
Now I'm recording.
Trying to fuck a guy's wife. Go ahead. Yell at me. Try to kick my ass.
You have to be really good at living in your own mind for sure.
Yep.
Oh, God. I did have a funny, just the fucking the guy's wife thing reminded me. I was at the USC Notre Dame game this weekend with my girlfriend.
Mm-hmm.
And we were just like in line for hot dogs. She's like, I'm going to go get a like lemonade down the thing. And this guy behind us, like, just, like, kind of looked like me, like, my same size and everything, just goes, you gonna go get a lemonade? He goes, I'm gonna go with her, and like looks at me.
What?
And then just walks my girlfriend to the lemonade stand like 40 feet away. And she's like looking it back at me the whole time. And I was like, did that guy just like fucking like day game me right now?
Mm-hmm.
Like I was just so confused. I was like, did I just get like fucking cucked over like lemonade?
I've never heard anything like that.
What did
life.
She say? How That's did it go? Wild. Did he start talking to her on the way over to the
yeah,
lemonade?
Yeah, she said she started walking and she, because we talked about it. I go, was that guy like trying to like cuck me like in front of you? Like not that I like I'm not like, oh, my girlfriend's going to go fuck that guy.
Right, right.
In like the car or something, but I was just like, was he trying to cuck me? And she goes, I think he was just so drunk that he thought that was like totally
right
okay to do.
He was just like, everyone's one big family.
Yeah, he got drunk
in row J.
He turned into Dom Toretto.
Yeah. That is funny.
But like he was doing me so he's like, dude, don't worry, I got her.
I got her, dude.
All right. Hey, thanks, guy I've never met.
Oh God. Yeah.
But it was funny going
he
to
just
the-
follows her the rest of the game. She's like, I'm going to go to the bathroom. He's like, yeah, I'm just going to follow
He's
her.
He's like, I got some tampons.
Yeah, we're taking the train back home. He's like, man, I'm so glad we got to do this together. Just follow. He's like up to my, I'm like unlocking the door.
He's like, we got to do this more often.
Yeah, he high fives me and walks in my apartment. All right, you have a good one, man.
He closes you out.
He closes me out.
Yeah, locks the door.
I have so little self-confidence. I'm just like, all right, I guess I'll go stay at Ben's.
You're like, at least the Sox won.
not even a game.
It was a Red Sox game, right?
No, USC.
USC Notre Dame. Okay, yeah. Different sport and professional level.
So far off base, it's
Dude,
impressive.
You know what's funny? If I turn to look at what time we are recording, I come back and I'm like, fuck, I stopped listening completely.
Yeah, I get that.
No, I shouldn't. I should be able to just like pay it. I should be able to pay attention to two things.
What are we at?
Like an hour. We're past an hour. Mm.
Okay. Do you want to do the Patreon then? Because we got to make dinner with our aunt.
We're not making dinner. We're going to a dinner.
We're going to dinner. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Where are you guys going?
Cafe Roma.
Mm.
Yeah.
Italian?
Yeah. She likes Cafe Roma a lot.
Nice.
Cafe Roma's good. It's Italian. They have like an $8 eggplant thing.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I love eggplant.
Katie loves it.
Yeah. Nice. Spring a cooked eggplant. On a plate.
Nice.
You should chow that down.
Not to piss you off, but I just want to let you know, full disclosure, I went to Apple Pan again today.
Okay, yeah.
Which I know you're like,
oh, you think I hate it?
Well, you made a kind of a jab at me last week. You're like, maybe you should start eating a little bit healthier. I also did a no-no. I had two cups of coffee today.
Good.
With caffeine.
I'm glad.
But I stopped at two.
We're close to the drinking.
Yeah. It's... You're slowly unwinding us.
I'm the only guy. I have to go to an AA without coffee. I go to the high. It's like the highest security in prison.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. No. I mean, I don't blame you for the way we're eating now.
You're eating like shit now.
We're eating like shit. It's the holidays,
it's
baby.
It's Thanksgiving.
It's impossible
week. Yeah.
To not like every.
I smoked a cigarette this week. I was
hell
crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's crazy. I thought you made like a covenant with God.
Yeah, but I broke it. So. Mm-hmm. If he's such a big man, why doesn't he kill me? my eyes explode and blood shoots out.
Yeah. Like the Ark of the Covenant.
Oh, Mr. Big Man. Yeah, my whole face melts. You guys still have to post the episode.
Mm. Okay, so that is the episode then.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry to all the severely handicapped and school shooter people we made fun
of. Yeah. Patreon.com/lemonparty. And like and subscribe. And
I guess this could be a Patreon too. Right?
Oh, or this who may knows? Be a Patreon.
May,
I guess
who
we,
knows?
We won't know.
We have no idea.
We don't know. All right. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Bye.